State Minister for Finance in charge of general duties, Henry Musasizi, made the comments while presiding over the fundraising towards the completion of St. Luke Catholic Church in Muhanga Parish, Chibale Diocese. The minister was representing the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa.
Not to overspend now, we should limit, control our spending. As government, we have done so, and also as individuals.
The minister also asked Christians to embrace the parish development model. According to the minister, once the government confirms that the circles of various beneficiaries are ready, they will release the funds.
What I ask them to do is to do all the necessary preparations. We have asked them to form circles. We are aware that they have formed, but some still lack a few things here and there. I appeal to all the circles, all the parish circles, to make them ready to start receiving the money as soon as practical.
Musasizi also used the platform to reassure the people of Chigezi on government's commitment to construct the pending tourism roads.
Plans are underway. We are looking, some we have already got funding, others we are looking for funding. Our objective is that in this term, we see most of these roads stomached because we must facilitate tourism as a revenue earner for this government.
The Rutshiga County MP, Roland Nyomgenyibish, disputed Musasizi's argument on inflation, saying that the government would rather focus on boosting local production potential than condemning expenditure, which is a driver to the development.
For this economy, is for production to increase, is for people to get income through government interventions and programs, is to give tax holidays to big manufacturers, not the foreigners. The foreigners are coming.
During his sermon, Father Lauben Mubangizi, the pastoral coordinator of Kabale Diocese, asked believers to focus on developing churches. At the event, 298 million was raised in both cash and pledges to complete the construction of the church. Report by Job Namanya for the news.